I'm Cormac McSweeney in the budget lockup, where the Trudeau government's fiscal plan has now been released. And to talk a little bit more about it, I'm joined by John Geddes, McLean's Ottawa bureau chief. So, John, you've had a chance to look over this big document. What do you think?
I think it's a modest document in the big picture way, and some of the small items, including ones that we weren't really focusing that much on. There are some really interesting things. There's big money for First Nations health care, for example, not something that was flagged much in advance. Very significant money for paying for military disability and health claims, something that wasn't discussed, barely discussed in the budget. Big numbers, billions of dollars there. So a few interesting items, as there usually are. On the overarching themes, very much as advertised, the minister's trying to emphasize gender equity, equality, innovation, the kinds of things that Minister Morneau is kind of trying to put his personal stamp on.
Okay, so pharmacare was another big topic going into this budget. What do we or don't we see in terms of a pharmacare plan?
Much more in the latter. There is no pharmacare plan in this budget. What we've realized, because there's no numbers, there's no details, is that the Trudeau government's rhetoric and behind-the-scenes discussion of it seems to have been much more of a political positioning thing than a budget measures thing. Maybe next budget we'll see some numbers for pharmacare. This is, at this point, a planning exercise, a fact-finding exercise, rather than a budget exercise. So a bit surprising, because you raise expectations there'll be something about that in a budget and then don't deliver. Inevitably, there's a sense of disappointment.
And what is the political motive out of that?
Well, I see two possibilities. One is that the NDP has been making some hay, Jagmeet Singh, on promising pharmacare. They didn't want that to become an issue that was stamped as an NDP priority and not a Liberal priority. And then there's also the fact that we are 2 years out, but roughly, from a federal election right now. Only one budget after this one. So if they want to start getting their ducks in a row to do something in 2019, probably around now they have to start doing that tough planning.
Okay, still no plan to get back in black. We still see deficits as far as 2022, 2023. Is that a mistake in this time of uncertainty with the U.S. and questions about NAFTA renegotiations?
All these things are seen as points of international comparison, and the gamble the Trudeau government is taking is that by keeping their debt to GDP ratio, sort of the size of our debt and deficits relative to overall economy, lower than our competitor nations in the G7, people we benchmark ourselves against, they're assuming international investors will look at that and go, Canada still in deficit, still in the red, but not as bad as some other countries, and edging in the right direction. So that's the policy. So far, that seems to have been working okay since Canada plunged back into deficit in the 2008-2009 period. So Minister Morneau is keeping his fingers crossed that international jitters don't worsen to the point where that starts to look like a liability for Canada.
Should there have been another contingency fund or more contingency in this budget?
I don't think so, Cormac. And the reason I say that is because we're now in the era where private sector projections make so much a part of the budget. And the minister points out that even if the low end, even if the most pessimistic private sector economist projections come in, it only worsens Canada's budget situation by a few billion a year. A few billion is a lot, but it's not a lot in the context of this kind of macro deficit spending sort of outlook.
All right, excellent. John Geddes, McLean's Ottawa bureau chief, thank you very much. And I'm Cormac McSweeney in the budget lockup for City News.